Good evening and welcome. My name is Lorraine Carter, and I'm the Director of McMaster Continuing Education. And it is my distinct pleasure this evening to host a panel that involves four alumni of programs that we have offered through McMaster Continuing Education. Before we get to the panel, I'd like to start with an acknowledgement. McMaster University recognizes and acknowledges that it is located on the traditional territories of the Mississauga and Haudenosaunee nations and within the lands protected by the Dish with One Spoon, One Pond Agreement. As I reflected briefly this afternoon on the acknowledgement, two thoughts came to my mind. It is about agreement and coming together. It's also about sharing. The Dish with One Spoon is about a situation of sharing. So I hope this evening has been a coming together for you and an opportunity for you to take away great information that might help you on your educational and professional journey. It is our purpose to do good sharing with you this evening. So at this particular point, it is my, again, distinct pleasure to introduce to you Adam Smolak. Adam is the Managing Director with Film Training Manitoba, and Adam comes to us this evening from Winnipeg. So good to see you, Adam.
Thank you.
And next, I'd like to introduce Crystal Kennedy. Crystal is a registered nurse with Homewood Health Center. And Crystal, again, you have had opportunity to be with Continuing Education for a while now, and I'm so glad that you're on this evening journey with us too.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Perfect, Crystal. Tracy Gibbs is a project manager with Hamilton Council on Aging. Important work. And again, Tracy, it is always a pleasure to connect.
Thank you for having me.
Delightful. And Tyson Dimayaga is with community engagement and content specialist work with the YMCA, of the Greater Toronto Area. So Tyson, it is again a real pleasure to have you here this evening.
Thank you for having me, Lorraine. My pleasure as well.
Great. We have put together the panel questions such that we want people to hear a little bit about your studies and some of your insights in terms of being a learner and possibly the contributions that the learning may have had to your career choices and your personal development. So I'm going to start with you, Adam, in terms of this first question. I think it'll be one that everybody will, have pretty significant ease in responding to. Would you be kind enough to tell us a little bit about the program that you took with Continuing Education and when you did that program, Adam?
So I think I registered for the Business Administration program in, I believe it was 2018. And I think it took me about a year or 2 years to go through all of the programming for Business Admin.
Great. Thanks, Adam. So we'll pass the virtual ball now on to Crystal. Crystal, would you tell us, please, just a few remarks about the program that you took and when you took it?
Yeah, so I took the Health and Social Services Certificate, which encompassed taking 5 courses. I started it in fall 2020, and I finished it this past spring 2021. I finished that, got that certificate in 2021 of spring. So it was a really good time.
You did some motoring through the program to certificate program in that length of time. Good for you, Crystal. Well done, for sure. And Tracy, can you tell us a bit about the program that you took?
Sure. So from 2016 to 2017, I did a 5-course program that was called Leadership in Community Engagement, which was a certificate program. And then more recently, I actually took a Leadership in Communications and Project Management course. And that's really for the learning credits towards my project management professional to write my exam and qualify for that. So that's my journey so far with CCE.
Okay, to be continued, perhaps.
To be continued.
Yes, well done, Tracy, for sure. The example of the lifelong learner. Mm-hmm. And Tyson, if you'd be kind enough to tell us what you studied with continuing education and approximately when.
Sure. So I started my business administration certificate in the fall of 2016. I was very new to the country. I was a newcomer by then. And I took that program for over 2 years. I did a part-time study, online study, as I am based in Toronto. And after that, I took a break and continued the certificate program into the business administration diploma with a focus on marketing. I took that from 2019 to 2020. So I finished right when the pandemic started.
Perfect timing in a certain kind of way, I suppose.
It was. Yeah. I had a lot more time during the pandemic. I wish I had more courses, but I was done.
Right. So you've mentioned the idea that our programs are online, and we were principally online before the pandemic. But obviously the pandemic has moved the needle forward on that. But it does appear that the vast majority of adult learners have benefited from the flexibility and accessibility of online programming. So thank you for highlighting that. And likewise, the people, and I've heard it from a couple of you this evening, that our programs are definitely tailored to individuals who are working, who need flexibility, who need part-time. So those would be some takeaways from your remarks. So I'm going to start with you, Crystal. I'm going to give you the heads up. Here's the second question. Could you tell us a little bit about your experience as a student with continuing education? And, you know, how do you think your program has shaped you professionally and personally, or helped you succeed professionally and personally?
So again, I am a mental health and addictions nurse. I've been working full time for the past couple of years. I think that this program, what I took was, I took five courses for in health science, health and social services, which included a couple addictions courses. I think that it really helped because as a nurse, I think actually in any profession, it's really important to continue to expand your knowledge and keep your knowledge up to date. Mental health and addictions is something that is continuously changing and we're continuously learning more things about it. So I like to keep my knowledge up to date and current. And I found my experience to be really good. It was, you know, I did it, obviously it was all online. It was virtual. I did it during the pandemic, which is a little bit stressful, but I found it helped to keep me, you know, really focused and motivated. And even doing it full time with those courses, I was really motivated to do it in the sense that I knew how much it would help my profession as a nurse. And again, personally, it helped keep me, you know, kind of sane during the pandemic, you know, having something extra to do and not just be stuck at home when I wasn't working. So it was a really interesting experience to do, you know, during this time frame.
Thanks very much, Crystal. So I hear something there around personal motivation as well as the professional development that in your field, healthcare is essential for sure, but probably in every field. And we're likely going to hear more about that. So Tracy, I'm going to pose it to you again. You know, how did you feel or how do you perceive the learning that you've done? And you've done some great work in two programs assist you professionally and personally.
Sure. Thanks, Lorraine. I think first and foremost, the program was influential in the trajectory of my career. So when I took the certificate program in leadership and community engagement, I was introduced to like new and progressive concepts around leadership and the practice of community engagement. And I think that really inspired me to think about what I wanted to do in my career. And so I, you know, I invested in those specialized skill sets. And I think that has really, like, it inspired me to go that route, but it also really informed the development. Like I started a consultancy business last year. And I have two really great contracts with the Hamilton Council on Aging for project management, doing exactly the kind of work that was inspired by that program. Secondly, I mentioned the qualifications and specialized skill sets. I think that that really sets me apart now in this field, which has led to new opportunities for me. And then, of course, the enhancement of my network And like my peers were people with similar interests. My course instructors and the faculty are extremely knowledgeable, connected, and passionate and about student success and their work. And so I developed relationships that have since led to collaboration opportunities post-graduation.
Fabulous, Tracy. You know, you've had an opportunity to first do some real shaping around your own thinking and your own journey. And then clearly you've just taken it from there. So congratulations to you. Well done. Very well done. So Tyson, how about yourself?
Well, my learning journey with McMaster has definitely been, I say, if I may say, unique and fruitful. As I mentioned earlier, I was a newcomer to the country in 2016. I got to research and know about the program. At that time, it was only McMaster who was serving, or a few, McMaster was just one of the few schools that was offering online learning. And I was in full-time work. I landed a job in a bank. But at that point, I wanted to switch my career. Like my bachelor, I had a bachelor's in from the Philippines, which is focused on healthcare, a bachelor's in science, and then I was working in a bank. And I was thinking of how to connect them and tie them up into a career path that I was wanting when I moved here. So at that point, I knew McMaster's program, the certificate in business would be a good start. But I still wasn't sure, like, what kind of business pathway did I want to? And that's why I took a year off. And from that year off, I decided that I wanted to take a path in marketing. So I made a focus on that. And again, pre-pandemic, I've seen how digital marketing has been a backbone of every industry. As you know now, everything's digital. And I said, you know what? What I learned from the school is, you know, you go with the trend. I get to ask my teachers. We were given real time and relevant knowledge on the industry. So that helped me cross my path and jump from banking into marketing, which I'm enjoying right now. Working for a nonprofit organization, helping other immigrants as well.
Thanks so much, Tyson, for highlighting the fact that you have come to Canada, and obviously you wish to make a life that is good and positive. And the marrying up of your experience coming from the Philippines with what were opportunities here in Canada, I think education may have been the bridge for you, perhaps, and meeting some of those instructors that you've mentioned. Yeah.
Yes, definitely. It really bridged the gap that was between my former education and experience. It enabled me to get that Canadian education and made me ready for the workplace.
And that's what we are trying to do. That's what we aspire to do. So Adam, the volleyball has come your way in terms of some remarks about your experience as a student with McMaster Continuing Ed and conceivably how it has helped or assisted you in terms of personal and professional development.
Thanks, Lorraine. I'm a huge fan of this program that I took, the Business Administration program, and just in general, I'm a fan of all of the programs that McMaster Continuing Education offers because I think it's perfectly calibrated for working professional people. I was in a situation, I'd been working for my company for, at that point, about 14 years, and I started off in an introductory position where I was a front desk business admin, or sorry, administrator, and I kind of moved up from position to position, and a few years ago, the executive director told me, I'm planning on moving on from the company and you should consider applying for this executive position in the future. And I immediately thought, you know, I had experience with human resources. I had my CPHR, my designation, but going from a middle management role into an executive role is really different. And so what I did was I looked at all of the continuing education programs in the country, everything in Canada, every university, every college that was offering programs. And I found this program at McMaster. And at first when I saw it, I really thought, what's the catch? Like this was so calibrated directly for someone that was working. And it's so difficult for someone like myself that's a middle income working person to just, I can't stop working because I have a mortgage and I have a lot of other responsibilities, to sort of just stop and go back and take a bachelor or a master's program. And so when reviewing this particular program, it was the ideal fit for a middle manager to take this program and then develop my skills and really put myself forward in a big way for the executive position. And what was really great about the program, it was so stackable that I could go in a bunch of different directions. So I took the general business admin diploma, but it specializes so you can have a finance, a marketing. There's a number of different sort of tiers that an individual can go down. And so really for me, when I looked at the program, it had a finance component, it had a marketing component, it had a business fundamentals component. And it really was just the fantastic fit for me personally. And to just go one step even further, anyone that's in this chat section or this session today that's watching this video, I would really say to you, do yourself a favor and really look over all the programs McMaster is offering, and even maybe book a time with someone at the program, because that's what I did. I spoke to someone on the phone and I had them walk me through the program and the various options. And I was just really blown away with how great of a program it was, how well tailored it was for me. So I registered, I signed up, I took programs at my own pace. And eventually, you know, going through the program, I ended up getting that promotion that I had wanted. And I feel that this program very much helped me have not only the skills, but a really great argument during the interview phase to say, I took on additional training to be able to move on to this position. So long answer there, but I really feel like I want to cover that off.
Long answer not. It's the right answer to, say to someone, I need to tell you this story. And that is what you have done here. So what I have heard is that in terms of lifestyle and personal responsibilities, it worked. And again, that it was an important lever for you to be able to progress and advance. And it is very difficult for an employer not to be impressed by, as we have among the four of you, commitment to additional learning and personal and professional development. So thank you very much. So the next question, and I'm going to start with you, Tracy, so that's the heads up. What advice might you give to someone who would be thinking about attending McMaster Continuing Education?
Yeah, thank you. I think that my kind of biggest piece of advice, you know, specifically to McMaster Continuing Education, would be to say that they will have the support that they need to be successful. And I think it was just really important for me. I remember back when I was doing the certificate program, you know, I have three children, my partner is a shift worker, I was in this program, I was also completing another degree program full time. And although I'm really privileged to be able to go back to school, it was really overwhelming at times. And so throughout this program, McMaster understood they understand life's complexity and the demands on people who are furthering their education while working, raising a family or caring for others, or experiencing hardships. And so I think that the faculty and the instructors are incredibly supportive there, and that they will help you navigate achieving your goals and success in your programs. That certainly was my experience at McMaster's continuing education.
Thanks so much, Tracy. Yes, we all need different supports in terms of our learning journey, and what you've described is a complex situation. So thank you. I would then invite Tyson to tell us a little bit about advice or a reflection that you'd share with somebody considering studying at this time with us.
Thank you for that question. So for someone who's considering studying at this point, first of all, put down your goal. Yeah, it's definitely go first. What I personally have done for myself, I've did a SWOT analysis. If for those who are familiar with strength, weakness, opportunities, and threat analysis. So I analyze myself, the skills that I have, where I am, how will I get there, and if you feel that McMaster's program will help you get to the goal that you want, go for it.
Perfect. Thank you. Next, I'm going to ask Adam for some reflections in terms of advice or strategies you'd share.
I like the last two answers by both Tyson and Tracy. I really liked what Tracy had to say. I totally agree. I never felt like I was on my own at any time. And that was a little bit of a scenario where I was a little bit worried, you know, entering into an educational program was, you know, with my responsibilities with my job and other things that I do, was I going to be in a situation where I would crash and burn? And I really wasn't. I really feel like anytime I needed help, I called and I got someone on the phone. And I have to be frank about this. There were so many times I forgot my passwords, but yet yes. McMaster like took the problem away, and it was just everything that McMaster did made it so easy for me. And I'm not an academic. I'm a professional manager, and I work in the film and television industry, and I work in trades. And so I felt like I got the support that I needed as a working professional to take this program. And at no time did I ever feel like I couldn't just make a phone call or send an email. And every time it was a very quick response. So I think that's one thing I would like to just let everyone share with everyone is there was that component to this as well. It's very important to note.
Thank you, Adam. I think that says a great deal. Crystal.
I'm going to agree with everyone else as well. I obviously did this, my certificate during the pandemic, very stressful time. I'm a nurse. I was working full time during that time frame. And even with all my responsibilities as, you know, and working full time as a nurse, plus doing this program, like I said, I did 5 courses between fall and winter. And then, you know, personal life, I always had the instructors who were extremely supportive, really understanding, and they recognize that majority of this, not majority, but a lot of students are doing this to enhance their careers, and they're coming as adult learners. So they're working. A lot of people are working either part-time or full-time, or even just have their family life to manage. And the instructors I found were really supportive and understanding. If you had the initiative to reach out, they won't know what you're going through if you don't reach out and ask for support. And that's the one thing I always tell people to recognize that, you know, they're not psychic. They don't know. If you need help, if you're looking for some support, make sure you ask for it. You can't get support and help if you don't ask for it. And the other major thing I always say is, I actually say this to like anyone, even as a mental health nurse, I tell people, your bedroom is not meant as a study space. Do not use, like have a designated study space. Do not sit on your bed on your computer to watch TV, to read, to study, to do any work in there, because that will actually reduce your ability to sleep appropriately in your bed. It'll actually change the chemistry and the way your brain works. So know what? That is not a study space. That is not a place to do work. And make sure you have a designated space that you know that when you come into that spot, that's where you study, that's where you do your schoolwork. It'll really help to change your mode from being a spouse, a parent, a sibling, a roommate, an employee, to being a student. And that, I think, is really essential, is to put your mindset into being a student. That way you can be, you know, at your best.
Thank you very much, Crystal. I think what we've heard in a fairly unqualified way here is the concept of support, different kinds of supports, supports that Adam's described as coming from the staff environment. And Crystal, you've spoke quite candidly about instructors, and we work very hard to bring great people into our instructor pool. But you make an excellent point. It is important to ask if there is a need. And likewise, in this period called the pandemic, I think all of us need those reminders that there are still decisions we have to make to take control of our lives. And that might be to find a place that's maybe not the bed. And likewise, Tyson, the concept of setting goals and then simply saying, you know, I'm headed for that goal after you've done some serious reflection on it. So I think we could probably talk for an hour, but I know I'm going to get the great big hook very, very soon. So I need to ask Suha if, in fact, there might be a question or two that we could respond to from the chat.
So we do have three questions that came in. We have a couple of minutes to answer. The first question someone is asking, how do I prepare myself for online part-time programs with all the daily work of family and commitments?
So I think we'll just ask one person to respond to that. Who'd like to respond to that? How do I prepare for online when I've got many other commitments in my life? Crystal, great.
I think the big thing is, again, setting time aside for that, you know, planning, making sure that you have a schedule. Schedules are essential. I am a big, you know, advocate for checklists and to-do lists. And again, also be gentle on yourself. Recognize that you are a human being. You are one person. You can only accomplish so much in a day. So making sure that you at every point in time are gentle on yourself and acknowledge the hard work you are putting into this as being a, you know, doing part-time studies, but still having to family and work-life commitments. So like I said, I think the big thing is creating a schedule for yourself, having designated time, a designated workspace, and again, being gentle on yourself. So those are my big tips as, you know, working full-time and then doing the studying. So.
Thanks, Crystal. That's great.
Thank you, Crystal. Okay, and moving on to our second and final question, it's, did you do any experiential learning courses during your continuing education program?
Did anybody do experiential learning in your courses?
I think so.
Tyson, a few comments there?
Yeah, I think I did two of them. One is the one that is related, it's a UMI resource program. We did like a group work and made recommendation to an organization, a real organization, about how they can improve their services. And also when I took on my diploma in marketing program, we also did a marketing experiential project for our final project for that course, wherein we did also something like consultational and recommendation to another, to an organization who needed to upgrade or change their marketing strategy.
Okay. Thanks, Tyson. So I would just add one sentence to say that as much as we can, learning is to be grounded in real life applications, whether it be problem-based learning or case-based learning. And as you pointed out, Tyson, there are courses where there are opportunities to do work with a real-life business or a real-life organization and perhaps make some recommendations. So to the best of our ability, we do try to do that too. So I think we've arrived. I think I'm being told this. I want to thank the panelists. This has been a wonderful opportunity. I want to thank everybody who has been here this evening. We hope very much that you have learned things about McMaster Continuing Education and that we see you in a course or a class soon. And in the go forward, if at all you have some questions upon reflection, please be sure to reach out. As I think we've heard from Adam, we will get back to you. And again, I will close with that final thought that we hope very much this has been a good evening and that you will consider McMaster Continuing Education as part of your learning journey and your professional development life.